idea came from this view that the city has very interesting history and legacy, and this 500 years of how this city was born, how it has grown and what it is today, all this is very fascinating, as you've seen in the film. And I felt that this story needed to be told to larger audiences, and the best way to tell this story is through a film. We could have come up with a coffee table book or something like that, but I felt a film would be the best medium to reach to larger audiences, not just in Mumbai, but maybe to the hinterland, to all parts of India and all parts of the world. So therefore, we felt that this was an important story. And there are three essential ingredients that maritime is, of course, the major ingredient. That is why the movie is titled Maritime Mumbai. And the other two essential components being the commercial aspect and the cosmopolitan aspect. How these three, the maritime, the commercial, and the cosmopolitan, how these three are intertwined and how they tell the story of growth of the city. And getting this data, the second part of your question, how difficult and challenging it was. We wanted to be reasonably sure that all the data that is being projected and all the story that is being told is authentic. And therefore, we have the Maritime History Society in Mumbai, which indulges in maritime research or our maritime history. And they were the prime agency, which is also run by the Navy. And in my previous position as the Commander-in-Chief, I was also the chairman of this society. And this society provided us the useful inputs and the research material.
Talking about your team, how was the coordination and how you selected your team from the writers, the directors, to all the people?
This team was not selected by me. This team was selected by Mr. Singhania. But when I thought of this film around June or July of 2018, I felt this is an interesting story to be told. And as I mentioned earlier, this is a story around which a film can be made. And while discussing casually with Mr. Singhania, he very kindly agreed to join us and to be the producer for this film and to take this idea forward. And then the rest of the team was formed. Many people came on board, and then we had very good coordination. And I thought this was also a very good way of doing public-private partnership, because here the Navy was bringing in the information on the maritime history or the growth of the city, linked with trade and commerce, linked with the Navy. And Mr. Singhania and his team were bringing the entertainment part or the media part of this filmmaking part of it. So it was a very good public-private partnership, and we had excellent coordination.
Singhania, what do you have to say? How was the experience in directing a film as such, and what was the inspiration to direct the film?
Well, the inspiration comes from the fact that I'm a very proud Indian, and my family has been in Mumbai for the last 150 years. And whatever we are today, of course, we hail from Rajasthan, and my grandfather had a legacy of being someone in India. But Bombay has given us a lot. I'm a proud Mumbaikar. And when I got this opportunity from Vice Admiral Sir that we should showcase Mumbai, I thought that this is a very good opportunity for me and my family to give back to Mumbai by showcasing Mumbai that has never been shown before. I mean, we have seen this film a couple of times with a lot of friends and audiences, and they also tell us that we do not know the facts on how Mumbai was built in the last 500 years. So I think these things, you know, at the after the discussion that I had with Vice Admiral Sir, I thought that we should do it, and to associate with the Navy, who look after our safety of our nation, and you know, to work hand in hand with them on this thing was a big thing for me. So that made me decide that I should do this film.
So many a times news channels or general entertainment channels also showcase this kind of films. How are you going to get to the masses to showcase that film?
So that is something that we are now setting about to decide on, how we would like to distribute this film for the bigger audiences, whether it would be through the OTT platforms or whether it would be through theatres. But there are hardly any theatres which show documentary films. So we'll have to find other mediums on how we can, you know, take it to the masses. this film is for the masses, people have to see it. So I think me and my team will be deciding on this course of action very soon.
Sir, what about being associated with the project as such?
Yeah, first of all, good evening, everybody. Well, when Mr. Shyam Singhania asked me to do a film on Navy, well, I come from an Army background, so I know a lot about Army and the Air Force, but not much about the Navy. So it was an opportunity which I could not let go. And once we started working with the Navy together, we got to know so many interesting stories about the origin of Bombay. And that is how we associated initially with the research work with MHS, working with my team. We did a lot of research. We went on for about 4 months before getting the script approved from the MHS, from the Navy. And yes, what you see is the result of this film.
Sir, you have bent down the story of being a writer. So what were the challenges? How did you bend down and make it so realistic as this?
So again, me and Saket, sir, we both from defense background. And once the opportunity came from the Navy, it was actually our good fortune that we were associated with something like this. When we received all the information from the MHS, it took us a while as to how do you put in the narrative of Mumbai and associate that with the Navy. Because for me, let's say as a viewer, as a citizen of this country and a resident of Mumbai, when I travel and I look at the naval walls in Colaba, you always wonder what is behind that. So for me, that was that fascination that I am telling that person's story who doesn't know what is beyond this. And a lot of history resides behind that. So it was just stemming from that. And the idea being that, you know, like Sir said, these 500 years have actually shaped the Mumbai of today. Where we are today is because of these 500 years. So, you know, we just had to follow the chronology of the dates. And, you know, like you have seen, from the Portuguese to the English and later the post-independence, how we took over. So it was ready-made. The Navy gave us everything that we needed. All it needed was us to just bring in our cinematic, creative inputs, and it was done.
Sir, talking about the recent Pulwama attack, you know, 42 CRPF soldiers sacrificed their life. What do you have to say about that? Whenever a sacrifice happens, only then, during that time, the media soaks up that kind of news. It's very important to soak in the daily struggle of a soldier to a medium, whether it be channels or, you know, any other medium.
Yes, I agree with you, and the hard work put in day in and day out, and the sacrifices made by the personnel of the armed forces and their families, I think need to stay in focus. And at the same time, the armed forces personnel continue to work with the dedication and commitment, irrespective of what difficulties and what losses they have to undergo.
So I agree to the same thing that, you know, the entire defense, whether it is the Army, Navy or the Air Force, they work selflessly for our safety, and we must recognize of their sacrifice and the effort that they put in to protect us.
Yes, obviously, see, whenever something like this happens, media comes up, but we as Army kids growing up with our parents, we hardly met our father. He was always in the field areas. We know the hardships. I think it's the only profession which is selfless, and they're there to take the bullet, or they're there to take the danger for a common citizen. And you know, we hope that they understand this. It's much more than a normal sacrifice.
I think the trend is changing. I think people are more aware of what our security forces are doing, and thanks to the media, they're also backing them a lot more. People are vocal and they're talking about giving their opinions, whether it be on social media or through television. And it's a good thing, because our security forces were in the background for a very long time. Now they need that. We're very proud of what they do, and I'm sure a solution of this will also come through.
While you know, there are naval parts in this film, But it also, as I mentioned, it has the commercial part, the stock exchanges, the growth of the trading, the commerce part, the people from other communities, shipbuilding, port trusts, railways, many other aspects have come into this film. And the second main intention was that a large number of people are not perhaps aware of some of the basic things. As the film brings out, why Marine Lines or Marine Drive is called Marine Drive is perhaps not very commonly known, and because the Marines used to live there. And so sometimes, you know, these things are important to reach out to people, because it is good to know your history and your legacy. And for all of us in Mumbai, it is important to know how the city grew. And these small little nuggets need to be sort of communicated to people of all age groups, you know, whether young people in schools or to older people, youth, everywhere. I think this story needs to get to a larger number of people. That part is going to be handled, as I mentioned, by Mr. Singhania, as to the promotion part of this film, because since they have produced the film, the distribution, promotion, those aspects are being handled by them and not by the Navy. But we are keen that it reaches larger number of people in India and outside India as well.
Some celebrity comes in and joins hands with us.
There is a venture of Netflix also.
Want
to know about what the venture is all about?
Sorry?
Regarding Netflix.
Yes. So we are trying to talk to OTT platforms, not particularly Netflix. We're trying to talk to various OTT platforms on how this film can be distributed and can reach out to the people.
इस आधे घंटे के डॉक्यूमेंट्री फिल्म में पूरा इतिहास छुपा हुआ है. बॉम्बे कैसे बना, बॉम्बे की शुरुआत कैसे हुई, बॉम्बे, मुंबई, मुंबा देवी, ये कैसे बना, इस पे ये डॉक्यूमेंट्री है. और मैं बड़ा सौभाग्यशाली हूँ कि मुझे ये डॉक्यूमेंट्री देखने मिली. इसके मेकर्स आई थिंक नेवी से जुड़े हुए हैं, तो अगेन प्राउड वाली बात है कि नेवी हो, आर्मी हो, इनके साथ बैठना या इनके साथ खड़े रहना सिविलियन के लिए एक ऑस्कर अवार्ड से कम नहीं होता है. मुझे बहुत आज मैं गर्व फील कर रहा हूँ कि ऐसे महान हमारे नेवल ऑफिसर के साथ मैं बैठा हूँ. और इस फिल्म को नेवल वालों ने बनाया, नेवी वालों ने बनाया, तो मैं इसका नाम देना चाहूँगा नेवी मुंबई. इस डॉक्यूमेंट्री का नाम दूंगा नेवी मुंबई. नवी मुंबई नहीं, नेवी मुंबई. और बहुत बहुत दिल को छूने वाली डॉक्यूमेंट्री है, इतिहास है. आप देखते देखते 40 मिनट में खो जाओगे, आपको लगेगा नहीं कि आप इस दुनिया में हो, लगे एकदम एक इतिहास में, आप एक इतिहास का हिस्सा बन जाओगे. इतना इतना प्यार से इसे शूट किया गया, इतना अच्छे से बनाया गया. इसमें वीएफएक्स, मतलब ये समझते कि मैं इसकी तुलना अगर करना चाहूँ इसकी मेकिंग की, तो बाहुबली से करूँगा. बिल्कुल सही बात, बिल्कुल बाहुबली से.
सबसे तो पहले मैं सबको थैंक यू बोलना चाहूँगी, आप मीडिया का और नेवी ऑफिसर्स का, कि जिन्होंने हमें यहाँ पे इनवाइट किया. और ये हमारे लिए फ़ख्र की बात है कि इनके फंक्शन को हम अटेंड कर पा रहे हैं. और जो इन्होंने मूवी बनाई है आर्मी से, नेवी से रिलेटेड, एक्चुअल में क्या, मैं एक बिज़नेस फैमिली से बिलोंग करती हूँ, लेकिन नेवी में मेरे खुद के काफ़ी मेरे कज़न्स रहे हैं, आर्मी में भी रहे हैं, तो वो लाइफ को मैंने बचपन से देखा है कि कैसे नेवी वाले, आर्मी वाले अपनी फैमिली को, मतलब अपना सर्वाइव करके, वो हमारे लिए जो इतना दूर रहते हैं अपनी फैमिली से और हमारे लिए फ़ाइट करते हैं, तो ये हमारे लिए फ़ख्र की बात है कि आज हम इनके बीच में बैठे हुए हैं. तो मेरा एक सैल्यूट है आर्मी और नेवी वालों को, जो हमारी सुरक्षा के लिए हर जगह पर खड़े रहते हैं.
मैम,